Well, sometimes, you probably know this, it's hard to get things started, especially when it comes to organizing your home. Moore's organizing expert Vicki Norris is here to help us stop the procrastination and start getting everything in order. And it all starts with, why are we procrastinating? Isn't that right, Vicki?
It's so true, Molly, because procrastination is the cause of the pileup in our homes and our workplaces. But we gotta figure out, why are we doing this? Why are we not getting started with our projects? So today, I'm gonna share some very common reasons, but more importantly, the solutions for procrastination.
And I can't wait because I am the procrastination queen. So, why am I procrastinating?
Okay, well, one of the first things that we see all the time is that people have this misperception about time. They feel like they lack time. And sometimes it's not an irrational belief. We're overcommitted, we're exhausted at the end of the day. You and I chatted about that. That's so common for people that are overwhelmed. What we do is we do the dump and run, you know, in our homes. And so the only antidote that we've found after 20 years of organizing, Molly, is that people have to shift their perspective about time specifically. Now, there's 8,760 hours in a year, if you can believe that. And in a month, Molly, there's 730 hours. And so most organizing projects are going to take between 12 and 24 hours. But people are like, oh, that sounds like it's going to take too much time. I don't have that much time. But you have 730 hours in a month, right? Mm-hmm. So 12 to 24 hours, you know, kind of blocking it out is reasonable, and it's going to pay you back in peace of mind.
Yeah, and to be honest, a lot of us will binge watch a Netflix show
with that amount of time.
Right. So we do have that time.
We do have the time, right.
Okay, what's the second reason?
Okay, so the other one that is huge is motivation. People lack motivation. They're just totally overwhelmed. Now, pictured here is me sitting with a client, and we're going over all of her kitchen stuff. And she's got here 10 boxes, Molly, just of her plasticware, if you can believe that. We pulled that out of her kitchen cabinets, and our whole team is sitting here going with her through all this stuff, and she's so overwhelmed. So the tip here is to reward yourself for your projects and to partner with somebody, because it makes it so much easier when you are overwhelmed to have another person there with you. And so her reward, of course, is getting that kitchen organized for her. She loves hospitality. She loves hosting people. And so that was her reward. And then her strategy was to partner with a team to really help her get through that. So if you're lacking motivation, reward and partner.
Okay, I like that. Some encouragement.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
What's the third reason?
Okay, so the next one is just lack of knowledge. We feel like, well, I wasn't raised with organizing skills. I don't know what the steps are. I don't know what to do. That is a very disempowered attitude, right? And so what you want to do here is you want to take an empowered role of a project coordinator and start with what you do know. I mean, we all know how to do a pin board, right? So go and create an idea board, okay? Start with that. Then maybe build out a timeline and start gathering your team that you're going, so you're kind of ratcheting towards your organizing project by, you know, putting on your project coordinator hat. So yeah, you're empowering yourself because procrastination plays tricks up here. So you gotta start somewhere.
Totally.
Yeah.
And the fourth?
Okay, so the last one is money. People think they lack the money to get organized. Why? We see all these beautiful pictures online and we think, oh, it's gonna be so expensive. But the truth is, it doesn't have to be if you're resourceful. So the tip here is to prioritize your projects and execute. So the way you do that, Molly, is you create a master list of everything you wanna do, and then you hit those projects that are gonna bring you the most relief first. And if you can, choose one that doesn't cost anything, like tackling the junk drawer or the powder bathroom, something that you know you can get some momentum on. And that prioritization is gonna make you feel better and better and more empowered to just knock off that procrastination.
Yes, I love it. Vicki Norris, organizing expert, my personal life coach. Thanks so much. Get to it. Right now, or soon at least.
Well, right? We have a blog
okay,
on our
perfect.
Facebook page on procrastination this morning.
Awesome. Thanks, Vicki.
Hey, thanks for watching this video. Be sure you subscribe to the channel and check us out at restoringorder.com.